Welcome to this new add-on spotlight. In this add-on spotlight, we're going to look at MSFS Community Downloader created by Nicolas Constant. The tool is currently version 0.4.0, so it's not yet fully completed, but that will come in the coming weeks, months. So what does the tool currently support? Well, it supports to upload the community additions, mainly the cockpits and some liveries, which are available via GitHub. Currently validating if there's an update for content stored on Flight Simulator 2 is not available, but there were some requests, so let's see if Nicolas has, I'd say, some appetite of adding that, but also if that's legally allowed to do that. Currently the following add-ons are supported: the working title ones, the CT4, G1000 and G3000, the fly-by-wire A32NX. Keep in mind only the stable version, and also keep in mind that Fly-by-Wire itself has an installer. Heavy Division B78 X-Ray Hotel, the Salta 747, and then there's Asghari Airlines deliveries, the Fred G36 project, and the GP Logistics C152. It keeps the add-on listing. So there's a list of add-ons which are supported and allows you to install, update or remove the add-ons. So it's not really only downloading the add-on, but also installing or updating or removing if you don't like them. The community folder is auto-detected, so that's all kind of cool. So let's jump to the tool. In this case, you can see it's an open beta that's referring to the CG4. So based on what you selected, it will show you, okay, which add-on has been installed and if it's up to date, yes or no. In this case, it says installed unknown, version 0.12.5 is available. They couldn't find an old package with this tool. Please reinstall the mod to get the proper version tracking. So it looks like that the tool keeps, I would say, a repository of its own to keep track if it installed the latest tool. So let's install the CG4 in this case. So I'm gonna press install. So we'll download it, extract it, and now it's installed and you can see that the correct version is being displayed. Keep in mind that you need to at least install them once using this tool. After that, it will be tracked correctly. That could be one, I would say, improvement from my point of view, because I'm pretty sure that I've got most of these versions already installed. I don't want to install the A32NX because I'm using the developer edition. And you can see it goes really smooth, right? So here you can see the source, so you can also jump directly to GitHub if you want. And there's also the smaller information, Patreon and Discord, where you can jump to. This one, I don't have it installed. No need. And the G36, also no appetite to install it. Same thing is for the GPL C152. Other than that, it has the settings button or option, and it will by default figure out where you have installed or where your community folder is located. You can try beta versions of MSFS Community Downloader by going to the Discord. So that will give you the ability to test new features prior to they being released as officially available. This is where this video ends. Hope you liked it. If you want to keep your community add-ons updated, especially those who are hosted on GitHub, then this tool really adds some value. It keeps them up to date, right? You need to still click update, but hey, it will check it and warn you if there's an update available. So let's look at how this tool progresses in the future. And let's hope that new features will be added, like, for example, checking if a new version is available on Flight Simulator 2. Thanks for watching and see you next time.